In our oceans, there's enough power in the waves, tides, and ocean currents to power all of the homes here in the US. And so when I look out over Lake Superior, I see a lot of potential. My interests are really in the waves on the Great Lakes and on our oceans, partially to understand how much energy is available in those waves and how could we harness that energy, but also thinking about what sort of impact those waves have on our communities. One of the projects I'm working on now is using existing wave buoys, such as the one we just deployed on Park Point Beach. And it's a system that provides real-time information about waves and water temperatures for the local community. The National Weather Service uses this real-time information to issue daily rip current risks for anyone that's going to the beach. But it's also helping complete our story of what the wave climate might be like close to Duluth, Minnesota. In some of the big storms where 10-foot waves are crashing up on the shores near Duluth, there's enough energy just in the width of your arms to power nearly 50 homes. It's really exciting to think about harnessing energy from the waves here on Lake Superior. But before we do that, we need to better understand the wave climate throughout the Great Lakes. And that's what these buoys are allowing us to do. In the next few years, we're targeting to deploy and test new wave energy technologies here in the waves on Lake Superior. This unique location in Duluth and on the shores of Lake Superior really gives us a chance to pursue local research that has impact in our local community, but really has broader applications around the world.